Hello, I am Dr. Arundhati Hoskeri, an educationist by profession and an astrologer by passion. Today, I am going to talk about effects of retrograde planets on humanity. This is a very unique week for us when three major planets have retrograded. Saturn on May 11th in the sign of Capricorn. He has retrograded for 142 days now. He will remain in this condition till 29th of September. And Venus retrograded on 13th May, and he will remain there for 44 days, that is up to 25th June in his own sign, Taurus. Jupiter has retrograded just yesterday, that is 14th May in Capricorn. And he will remain there in this state, in this condition for 121 days, that is up to 12th September 2020. Actually, going retrograde doesn't mean hopping to the backward zodiac sign or moving one house behind. It is like when the speed of a planet, particular planet, is reduced, the planet slows down. All other planets are moving in their own orbits with their normal speed. That is how we feel that this particular planet is moving backwards. This all of us have observed and experienced, like, you know, when we were traveling by train. And if we are on a slow train and there is another train on the next track going with a very great speed or a faster speed, we feel that our train is going behind or going backwards. And there also may be a moment when we felt that our train is not moving at all. So that is a retrograde motion. That's what is happening with all these three planets, what I have mentioned. And actually, retrograde motion is a time for reflection. Say, for example, I'll just explain this phenomena to make you understand better. When we are jogging or running, or walking briskly, all our thought process, all our concentration is on that particular action. We are alert about the action, what we are doing. Our heart also is pumping, more blood, breathing rate is increasing, all the blood rushes through the lower limbs, and then we are going. And at that time, observe it next time, please. At that time, we are actually having minimum thoughts on our head, or we are slowing down on our thoughts because all our attention is on the action of running or walking and all that. And after you do this task, if you sit down at a place, you feel so fresh and comfortable. See, don't think it is only because of the physical exertion that you are feeling fresh. It is actually mind and body are always connected, right? So it is because you slowed down your thought process, you are feeling it better along with that exercise regime. On the contrary, you start walking very leisurely, whether it is Marine Drive, you know, stretch of for walking, or whether it's a Worli Promenade, anywhere, like you walk. For the first 5-10 minutes, you will observe around, oh, the sea is looking very beautiful, and you look around with people, you look around the lighting, everything. But after 5-10 minutes, when you start moving, walking leisurely, so many thoughts start coming in your head. And so many persons pop up in your head, like, you know, your nasty boss or your wicked colleague or your wicked mother-in-law or daughter-in-law or your relations, not always negative, like, you know, I told it in a lighter vein, even your own childhood memories, your mother and your father, and, you know, like your moments you spent with your children. So many things, like, you know, thoughts have no end. They start popping up in our head. So it is exactly like this. So when the planet is going at the normal speed, everything is happening normally. When it slows down, it reflects. So we also reflect when we slow down. So that is where, what is the basic principle of yoga? Yoga says slow down. Slow breathing, slow actions, and slow down your thought process. In a way, even jogging and running or whatever you are doing, like when you slow down your thought, that itself is meditation. Meditation does not necessarily mean always sitting in a corner and, you know, taking name of God. All right. So retrogression or retrograde planets give us an opportunity to reflect, introspect, and be candid with our own selves, to tell the truth to our own selves. Most of the time, What happens is we are scared to know the truth about our own selves. And, what happens is we come up with all sorts of excuses, arguments, and justification to believe that whatever we are doing is always right. Now, just think about it. If you are always right, if you are always good, then you should not be on this earth. You should be in the heaven, because that is perfection, right? Nobody is perfect. We're all humans. We all err. We all make mistakes. But the beauty is you understand your mistake and reflect on it and try to mend your ways. Don't repeat it. That is the, well way to live our life. And so we need to, it's the time now to break those shackles and see our face in our own mirror of our own mind. This is called as Sakshi Bhava, or understanding our own selves. Be truthful to our own selves. All right. Now, let us quickly see how this is going to affect all of us, all the retrogrades. Let us check with Saturn. Now, Saturn is not always a bad planet. He is a structured thinker. He is hardworking. He is just. He loves obeying law and order. But he's a ruthless teacher. And, he went retrograde on 11th as I explained earlier. Now, all these traits of Saturn, in fact, you can see in people whose zodiac sign is, Capricorn and Aquarius, Makar Rashi or Kumbha Rashi, because they are from their, mentality or whatever personality is shaped by Saturn's traits. And Saturn prompts us to look into our karma kshetra, because he rules the, in the Kala Purusha's Kundali, he rules 10th and 11th houses. 10th house is the action or our karma kshetra, and 11th is the reward, what we get out of that. So what is our work culture, what efforts we are putting, and how just we are, or how honest we are in our work, and what is the kind. So the reward depends upon your actions. If you have a power and if you are going on troubling others and always trying to pull others down, you will never get blessings. So Saturn, you are going to meet your end. Temporary successes are always there, but definitely there will be a hammer on your head one day. So that is the thing. So, and now it is time for us to reflect about our job. Am I happy in the workplace, or am I happy with the job itself, what I am doing, or should I be doing something else, or should I change my career path? And if so, what are my strengths? What are my weaknesses? And how do I strengthen my strengths and, work on my weaknesses, weaken our weaknesses. And, this is not just for people who are educated or having a white collar job. It is for all class of employees. Actually, even the menial workers who have right now gone back to their homes, they all flee from their villages and come to tinsel towns like Mumbai for the lure of money and for the lure of city life. Now they also will start reflecting, what am I doing? Is it right? Is it worth going and struggling there? What will I do if again there is a situation of COVID-19 kind of a situation? What am I going to do? Should I go back or should I not go back? So this is the thought process right now in there. So they are in the process of considering and reconsidering their choice. So wherever you are and whatever you are doing, and he will make you work hard. That is another trait of Saturn. So he is not an easy teacher. He will make you work hard, and then only he will reward you. And Saturn is also a melancholic planet. And, he causes a kind of feeling, low feeling, and depressive moods and pensive moods for no specific rhyme or reason. You are right now also, people are going through this. You ask anybody, people are depressed. Now they are trying to cheer themselves up. They are holding antakshris. They are having social media. Then, online teaching, online learning, everything. But you can't do it 24/7. You are completely away from actual human interaction. This is again separation. Separation is under trait of Saturn. So this is separation always doesn't mean separating from people. It is also separation from your routine. separation from your work atmosphere, separation for your from your colleagues, separation from your friends. And you know, people, like right now also we are restructuring our lifestyle. See, again, whenever something existing thing collapses, then only there is something new built out. That is what is happening right now due to this retrograde effect. And people who are engaged in iron and trade and iron trade and land dealings and constructions, mines, and they will start going back to their business and they will start making some profit. And another thing, like, you know, Saturn is very fond of meat. So people who are meat sellers or, you know, poultry owners, they may start making money again. This is how Saturn is going to, you know, affect. I should make another video. There's so much of material on this, but right now I'm restricting it to this only. Now let us consider retrograde of Venus. Now who is this Venus? Venus is also a teacher and he is a Daitya Guru. Daitya Guru means teacher of demons. But teacher is a teacher. He has some valuable lessons for humanity. Now, when Venus also is, you know, like responsible for pleasure, all sorts of pleasure and comforts and, you know, happy-go-lucky type of lifestyle and, you know, spending on perfume, spending on exotic things, anything that comes under the, you know, control of Venus. But right now, with his retrograde motion, he will teach us to exercise control over extravagance. He will teach us to live a frugal and simple life and to save something for the future. See, this is already happening right now. If you think, you know, at home when we are staying, we are not going to, you know, sit with, we are not going to spray Gucci, then Prada and Ghost and sit at home. We are not going to wear our expensive clothes and sit at home. We are not throwing expensive parties. We are not going out and socializing. So this all, in a way, we are saving money. Not that you don't have money. However amount of money you have, you never know what the situation is going to be. Because no amount of money can save you. That is actually a human arrogance. I have so much of money, what, I can do anything? No. When the, see, right now only COVID situation, think about it. You may be having hundreds and crores of money, like, you know, those who have. India is a country where rich are super rich and there is a class poor and there is a middle class. So whatever way we are having, enough resources we are having at our own levels, but what is the use of it? Like this COVID-19 has created, and this is a time to reflect and learn again a valuable lesson. So that is what Jupiter also, Venus cautions us. Now, Venus also makes us reflect on our relationships. He is now signaling us where to hold on and where to let go. If something is not working in a relationship, just let go. There's nothing right or nothing wrong. Sometimes things happen, just let go. And it shows a kind of transformation in relationships, this particular transit of Venus. Of course, whenever anything, any change is to happen, always there is a discomfort. No change is suddenly accepted. There is a, you don't expect, you know, accept it yourself or it causes discomfort, but you will overcome that gradually. And Venus also makes you discover your inherent talent. And also cautions you, it's not a good time for heavy investment. He will create interest in astrology and mantras. And, you know, during this period, if you are not directly involving into chanting of mantras or, you know, doing some, meditation or whatever, at least there are people watching, you know, Mahabharata and Ramayana and Bhagavat on there, that are, you know, aired on the TV or YouTube. So this is how you are going to get into some spiritual zone, like some things you are going to learn. And film industry and performance arts will kind of slow down right now. And if there is any health problem popping up from nowhere, please don't actually neglect it. You need to immediately attend to it to avoid further damage. And Venus also favors natural remedies like yoga and pranayama, and you know, because he, as I mentioned right now, he is also a Daitya Guru, and he is also very, very concerned about humanity, and he bestows with a lot of blessings on humanity. One more thing I forgot to mention about Saturn. Saturn always cautions us, or Saturn always identifies himself with the low class workers or low class employees. And what happens is, like, if you need to, during this period or throughout your life, if you want to seek Saturn's blessing, be very considerate and you know, show that respect what is due for the people who are working under you, your subordinates and your servants, or your whatever kind of class they are working. Actually speaking, I'm very compassionate about these kind of people. I don't understand why people have to shout and scream to get the work done. There's no need. See, we are in a position to, we have to correct, we have to mend the ways, and we have to get the work done. But that can be done in a polite way with the, you be stern, you be assertive, but you don't have to scream and insult a person and bring tears into the eyes of poor people. So then Saturn will never ever trouble you if you are compassionate towards your subordinates and workers. Now I'm going to discuss about Jupiter. Jupiter is a benevolent planet. He's called a Sattvika Grah. Sattvik means very, very nice, and you know, he has no malice on his mind and always helpful, always a do-gooder, and always want to bestow humanity with the blessings and conferring them with success and fame and wealth. Of course, as per their karma, nothing comes in life free. Okay, so he is a planet of wisdom and an abundant source of optimism and enthusiasm, and he helps us to reach our goals in life. Jupiter actually is the largest planet that has a mass of more than 300 times that of Earth. You can imagine the size. Jupiter takes approximately 12 years to go around the Sun, and Saturn takes 30 years to go around the Sun. That is, if Saturn is in Capricorn, to come back to say Capricorn, he will take another 30 years. Jupiter, it is a 12-year cycle. And he completes visiting all the 12 zodiac signs in 12 years. That means 1 year in one particular sign. Which actually, he, because of his huge size, every year for about 4 months, he slows down. That is what we call as retrograde motion. So if he is going retrograde every year, then why we are giving so much importance this time? As I mentioned to you earlier in the beginning, three planets going together in the retrograde motion is special. And also, as it is also every year, no other planet is so much talked about. Every year, Jupiter's motion is always talked about when he changes or when he goes retrograde. Okay, so because it is because of its frequency. Now, currently Jupiter is in Capricorn sign, owned by Shani, and he is debilitated. That's what we call Nichastha Sthiti. Okay, so yesterday, that is on 14th, he has slowed down and he has actually come to stand still. That is called Stambhi Bhuta Paristhiti. See, I mentioned to you in the, when I gave the example of a train, there comes a moment when we feel that we are not moving at all, only other train is moving. So it's exactly like that. So right now he is in the Stambhi Bhuta condition and he will start slowly retrograding. Actually, the motion is on. This is the phenomena what we observe and what we get. So this is the time for introspection, peeping into our own self and connecting spiritually with the higher self and also with others. See, actually, connecting with the higher self means we need not always think of only connecting with God. We have to connect with other human beings also. The day we realize that each and every human being around us, or each and every animal also being around us, is nothing but another Atma just like us, another soul just like us, and we all are reflections of that Paramatma, you will have no hatred or no love in your mind. Like, you know, you will start treating everyone equally. So you will, no vengeance, nothing. So to reach that stage, you need to slog, and you know, at least some percentage of it, if you reach also, your life will be totally different. So leave people to their karmas. Anybody who is wrong to you, also don't retaliate and don't abuse and don't give back. Like, they have collected their karmas and that is there for them. Karma is like a shadow. Whatever we do will not, you know, leave us. It is always behind us and, you know, to teach us a lesson. All right. And right now, Jupiter is also a planet of expansion. Right now, it is time for inward expansion. Okay, expansion is not always outward. Inward expansion is to seek truth. And so we need to work on ourselves. We can actually fool the entire world, but we can't fool our own selves. So we need to connect with our higher self, our own self, and understand what we are doing. Also, you have to ask a question. Am I happy in relationships? Whether it's not always with your spouse. With your spouse, with your children, with your parents, with your grandparents, with your siblings, with your friends and with your colleagues, anyone, like, you know. So you need to reflect and mend your ways. If you hurt somebody, if you've done something wrong, you know, you won't become small by going and apologizing and, you know, find closure to all that so that your mind is free. Actually, excusing others is we are not going to do a big obligation on others. We are obliging our own selves. Because I will be happy if I excuse people. So that's how you need to live. You need not carry your karmas to the next life also, that this one has done like this, that one has done like this. Leave to their karma. Let them, you know, enjoy what they have done. And also about job, like, you know, am I satisfied in my job? Or how could I do it better? He's a planet of, you know, again, blessings. And blessings will come only because of hard work. See, 10th house, I told you when I was discussing Shani is making you work and, you know, he will be rewarding you because he also owns the 11th house. But if there is no grace of Jupiter, there is no Ashirvad of Guru, nothing will come to you. I've seen so many people slogging and doing this, doing that, but nothing happens because they don't have the blessings of Guru. So Guru or Jupiter becomes very, very important for us. Now, Jupiter will have 3 sextiles. 2 Neptune and 3 conjunctions with Pluto, who are his elder brothers. Now, sextile means actually he will be, you know, when there is a, this is formed actually when when planets are 2 signs away from each other or about 60 degrees apart. So this is actually a positive harmony between the planets that opens up new avenues and new pathways for growth. At the same time, Pluto conjunction is not good. It's going to bring some at least, you know, problems. So we are going to get mixed results. If you think of Pluto, you know, like if you think of Pluto, this period may give rise to some kind of unrest, political unrest. And rebel, you know, whether the organization is small or big or whatever level or at the country, people might get, might revolt and come on the streets and start fighting for their rights. So all these things, and economic imbalance is there and difference of opinion, all these things are affected because of Jupiter's conjunction with Pluto, because Pluto is a malefic planet. And also, you know, like there is one more phenomena that is happening in June. I'll be making a separate video on that. That is the solar eclipse. Along with all these combinations and the effect of solar eclipse, there may be a kind of flood and, you know, storm or rains, like, you know, heavy and uncontrollable rains again this year before 30th of June or in the first up to first week of July. So that possibility is also there. So we need to understand that and make provision for in whatever way we can tide this situation. So Jupiter came to stand still on May 14, that is yesterday, at 27 degrees and 14 minutes in Capricorn. On July 14, 2020, Jupiter will be opposite Sun and he will be closer to Earth. Okay. September 12, 2020, Jupiter stations direct, like, you know, he starts moving direct at 17 degrees and 24 in Capricorn. October 11, 2020, Jupiter will square the sun. That means he derives energy when he squares the sun and he will start speeding up, moving ahead with speed. Finally, on December 19, 2020, Jupiter leaves Capricorn to enter the next zodiac sign, Aquarius. So, after December 20, more or less on a broader level, the things will start settling down. So, about the eclipse, solar eclipse that is happening in June, I'll be uploading another video. Actually, this solar eclipse, the sun is going to be shadowed by more than 95%, and it has got its own malefic effects, which will last for about 3 months on humanity. So, guys, if you have liked my video, please like, share, and subscribe. And thank you very much for watching. God bless. Shubham Bhavat.